So, thank you to the presenters. I'm Iker, the biologist.
Yeah. And I'm Carlos, the physician. So, I think I'm the only real doctor working at VSC, not accounting for those pretending to be PhD or whatever.
But yeah. So, doctor.
Yeah, tell me, Iker.
That you know everything.
No.
Why are we here, then?
Okay, so, oh, that's a very good question. That's what we are going to try to explain you today. So, you can imagine that someone like Iker being a biologist or me being a physician could be a little bit lost sometimes in a place like Mare Nostrum, as you can tell by the images. But we can assure you that we do a pretty interesting research, and that's what we are here trying to explain you what we do.
Yeah.
So since we are working on the life science department at the computational biology group, we mainly focus our research on the study of diseases and biological processes related to them. And our main interest is the study of cancer. So why cancer? Cancer is not only a disease, it's more than that. It's a social problem, it's a burden. And it's a challenge that we, all together, as a society, has to face in the years to come. So the numbers tell us that 1 out of 3 people in the world are likely to develop cancer on their life. I know that's a pretty strong number, but I will ask you to please keep calm, Iker, remain calm, because with the proper treatments and the actual treatments, more than 50% of patients that suffer the disease are able to overcome it. So this is a very important message, because we usually, when we hear about cancer, we think that, okay, this is the end, there is no way out, and this is not true. So this is the main message that we want you to take from our talk, and it's also an important message for society, because we always need to look on the right side of life, and it's very important, for sure. So what do we do here at BSC? So we study the DNA, and I think that the best way to exemplify what the DNA is trying to compare it to a script. So the DNA is a script which has the commands of life, and you need to execute it precisely. So sometimes there are errors, we call them mutations. Once you make some typos in your code, you need to debug them, and that's what we do. We just look for the code, in this case the DNA, and try to find where the errors are, and trying to, let's say, why are these things happening, in order to try to develop in the future a treatment to fix it. Exactly. So now that you know what do we study and why do we study, Iker is going to tell us about what's the final goal of all the research that we perform here.
Yeah, so thank you, Carlos. So the main goal in our research is personalized medicine.
What is personalized medicine? Everything.
Yeah, very cool term, isn't it?
Yeah.
Precision medicine. This is all the same, okay? We see it in the social media and everywhere. So in order to make you understand easily this concept, I will ask all of you to think about an Andrew football player.
Okay, I think I got one.
You too, Carlos?
I do.
Yeah, sure. Okay. So now imagine that you are the physician that have to come and treat these ladies, okay? And they tell you that they have a problem in their leg. Okay. So at that moment, you only know that. So you need to gather information. You need to understand if the problem could be in the knee, in the ankle, in the foot, in the hip, whatever. It doesn't matter. The main point is that you need to understand where is the origin of this problem, to try to understand it and be able to fix it in the proper site that it is occurring. So that is what it is, why it is personalized medicine. You need to understand what is happening to this patient independently of if it has a disease that you have already seen in another patient. So this very same way of thinking is what you have to use when you are thinking about cancer, Alzheimer, whatever. As Carlos said, DNA mutations are triggering the cancers, but the causative things could be a lot of them. So you have to understand what is leading to the cancer in each one of the patients. So you have to study the metabolism, the environment, the bad habits, all of these things that we do in biology. Okay? So you need to integrate all this information in order to understand what of them is leading to the cancer that our patient has. Because in the end, we don't want to treat diseases. We want to treat patients. So now that you understand this concept, Carlos will explain you one of the of the biggest improvements in the treatment of cancer in the last years, which is immunotherapy.
Yeah. So thank you, Iker, for introducing the concept of
personalized
medicine. So we can say that classically we have like three different options to treat treatment. That's been said: surgery, radiotherapy, and chemotherapy. And the problem with these treatments, especially with chemotherapy, is that it's a very aggressive treatment. It doesn't not only target cancer cells, but also affect healthy tissues. So it has lots of side effects. And that's why it's so important to try to study and develop new treatments more specific. And that's the case of immunotherapy. So what's immunotherapy? So this is like Star Wars. I don't know if there are many fans of Star Wars here. The main goal of immunotherapy is trying to awake the force that is within our bodies, which is our immune system. So it's very easy to understand. The immunotherapy tries to stimulate our defense so they can recognize the cancer cells and attack them. And this is mostly it. So it's like if you think about a vaccine, which the main goal is trying to build a defense against a virus, let's say, this is the same. So at the end of the day, we want to have a defense and we want to avoid these things.
Don't worry, I'm also from Barcelona, okay?
I'm a Real Madrid supporter, I'm sorry, I couldn't help it.
Okay, so we have been for 5-6 minutes talking about biological stuff and whatever, but we started saying, why are we here? Why BSC? No? So the reason is the same as all of you. We have a lot of data, okay? So we need Mare Nostrum. Thank you, Mateo. So the main point here, you have to think that a genome of just one patient is 250 gigabytes. And at the same point, we are not only analyzing if somebody has a cancer, but the metabolism, everything that I said before. So that is an exponential function. In the end, we have a lot of data that we have to integrate, and we need something that is able to make us take all that data and work in a real time frame. So just to end the presentation, we want to tell you that with great power
comes great responsibility.
Thank you all.
Happy
Merry Christmas.